Welcome to the 46th World Gymnastics Championships. Day here in the Hydro in Glasgow for these World Artistic Gymnastics Championships. It's the last day of the individual finals and we're going to be concentrating on the men. We've got the men's vault final, the men's parallel bars final and the men's horizontal bar final.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our...
There's the start list for the vault. We've got some big names in there, Kenzo Shirai, Donnell Wittenberg, as well as Marianne Dragulescu, who I'm sure will be doing his own vault. So first up, it was from the United States, Donnell Wittenberg. Came into this in eighth place. So this is his first vault. Gymnast must perform two vaults, and then it's an average of the two. So this one has a 6 start value. Oh, and that's the handspring front and a half there. Difficult vault. You can see there, running up, powers on, wraps in, 2.5 there. Good finish, well within the line. Just the half turn out there, spots the floor. That's a good, strong vault to start with and a great score, 15.1. So this second vault is very important. It's also got a huge start value of a 6.4. Focused. And concentration and down to business here for Donnell Wittenberg of the United States. Second vault. Charges down. Oh, and it's a double Sukahara with full twist. Well, two very difficult vaults. See there, wraps in. 6.4. The start value on this. Sukahara on there, you can see, half twist. Punches up in the air. Pleased with that performance. He scores 15.6 for that second vault with a total of 15.35, which puts him currently into the gold medal position. But next up, it is the man of the vault, really. His name is Marian Dragulescu of Romania, and this vault is his vault. It's actually named after him. This is the Dragulescu. It's a 6 start value. Handspring on, double front, the half turn. We've actually just seen Donnell Wittenberg also performing that. Straight on, punches high up. Just a step back there.
6.0 tariff vault.
There it is, wraps in for the half turn. He scores a 15.3 for that first vault. So now it's all about the second vault. Second vault, of course, must have a different entry onto. So he performed the handspring there. So he's gone now for a 6.2 start value. The entry to this must be different. Another big one with a 6.2. It's a round off entry, half turn, 2.5 twists. Well, he is pleased with that. really experienced gymnast here, and this really is the piece of apparatus for him. Look at that. Wraps in, 2.5 twists. So he's got a slightly higher tariff on this second vault. Good score on the first. And he gets a 15.5 on the second vault, so it's a combined score of 15.4, which pushes him straight up into the lead. Well, next up from the Ukraine, it was Oleg Vernayev. His first vault here also has a start value of 6. Charges up there. Oh, and it's the handspring double front again with the half turnout. So it seems like everyone is going for the Dragulescu. There it is again. Double and then into that half turn. Actually, that one was nailed very nicely from Vernayev. Launches on, handspring rockets into the air. 2 and then the half.
Later this afternoon on the parallel bars, where he is the world champion.
Well, second vault now, great score, 15.466 on that first vault. Now the second vault also has a start value of 6. And there you can see just mentally preparing the vault in his head. So again, second vault must have a different entry on. He's done the front handspring. Powerful up he goes. This time, Sukuhara on with the triple twist. Have another little look at that on the replay. See the half turn on, rips in, triple twist. That was a great vault. And look at the elevation there, launches himself into the air and he's able to whip in the triple. So, all important score on vault 2, 15.1, giving him a combined 15.283, which put him into bronze medal position. But this guy, Ri Si-gwan of Korea, came into this final ranked in first place, and he has 2 vaults here, both with a 6.4 start value. So let's expect something big. In he goes, handspring on. Double pike with the half turn. Well, again, it's a form of the Dragulescu vault. This time you can see he's actually performing it in the pike position as opposed to the tuck. Winds in for the half turn there. What a stunning vault. Well, the Dragulescu vault has definitely been a favourite here tonight. And there we see it in a different variation with a pike. Huge score, 15.6 there. So, what's he got for his second vault? It's another 6.4 difficulty. Very important, this second vault now. It's going to have a different entry on. Focus down now. 6.4, it's going to be big. It's a full twisting Sukuhara. Couple of paces back there, but he says, that's fine, I'll take that. Huge vault again. Couple of stumbles. Straight in. Full twisting, double Sukuhara there. Well, it's a 15.3, giving him a combined total of 15.45, which puts him straight into the gold medal position. And all the guys congratulating each other. Well, there it is, confirmation. Well, the reigning champion remains the champion here from Korea, Ri Sen-gwang. in second place. And the man with the vault that everyone loved tonight was Marianne Dragalescu. And in third place, Donnell Wittenberg. Well-deserved gold medal there. There you have the World Championships vault final medalists. Well, it didn't end there. It was over to P-bars, and again, the start list was looking very hot indeed. Well, first up, it was Oleg Stepko of Azerbaijan, came into this ranked third. Bit of a specialist on this piece of apparatus. He starts off nice, up into handstand there, very solid. Lovely work. To the one rail there, the pitch, and down to the Healy. Back up the pitch. Oh, straddle, the somersault, nice to the hold. Back up to handstand. This is a good work. Not a flicker there. There's the tippelt. Lovely in the Healy. Double pike to finish. Solid routine there from Oleg Stepko of Azerbaijan. Winds in there.
21 years of age.
And see those body lines. He swings through. Into that tip out there, to the handstand. Huge score, 15.966 for Oleg Stepko of Azerbaijan. Terrific. Well, next up, it was Yu Hao of China. Came into this ranked in fourth. Chinese, renowned for incredibly strong work on the parallel bars. And so off he goes, front pike, straight up. Nice. Double tuck there, between the bars. Oh, that's lovely. He's got a real flair about his swings. There's the peach. There's a pike double there, straight back up. Transferring between the bars. There's the bafsa. Up again. Secure on the handstand. Straight in. Whips up from the tippelt. Into the Healy. In for the dismount. Oh, the double front with the half there. Well, that was a very competent routine. Lovely work in between the bars. Swings well. There's that summy with the half twist between the bars. Difficult work. Whopping score, 16.216, which puts him straight into first place. Incredibly well deserved there. Well, next up, it was Oleg Vernayev of the Ukraine, came into this in first place. He's actually the reigning world champion on this piece of apparatus. It's a stunning start to handstand. Peach half. Peach to one bar. To the Healy. Accurate work. And again. Straight into the tapout. That's the Babsar. Up. Great control there. Moving around the bars. Oh, double front half off there. Well, another incredibly complex P-bar routine there. This time from Oleg Vernayev of the Ukraine. See there, up into the tapelt. Straight back. Double front, half. Well, he's the reigning world champion on this, but not today. 16.066. It's still a big score, but it was just not quite enough to get in front of Yu Hao of China. Another Chinese gymnast takes the parallel bars, this time Deng Xiaodi. He was fourth on this in Nanning. There's a double pike. Up to handstand. And there's another double pike. Back up to handstand. There's the peach. Peach half. And another double pike. Why not? Straddle front. And the Babsar. Up again to handstand. Well, this is flowing very nicely into the tapelt. Healy there. So, just the dismount to go now. Double pike. Well, you can see there on his face. He knows that was job well done. Very businesslike, this gymnast. Silver medalist here in Glasgow in the all-around. But it's a 15.966, which takes him into third. So it's not quite enough for a gold here. But as you can see there, China still took the gold medal in the form of Yu Hao. It was a silver medal for Oleg Vernayev of Ukraine. Nothing to give away his world title there. And a joint bronze for Deng Xiaodi of China and Oleg Stepko of Azerbaijan. There they are, the men's parallel bar medalists. Well, it was the final of these world championships, and it was what a way to finish on the men's horizontal bar. Always an exciting final. We've got two American gymnasts in there, and of course, Kohai Uchimura, that guy from Japan who wins a lot of golds. But first up, it was Darnell Laver, came into this ranked in first. That's his coach and dad in the background. So, this is an incredibly complex routine. Straight in. Winding up there. And it's the Kovac there. Nice. And another one, this time in the pike, the half twist. The Stalder, hop. Well, this is big. Catch Kuchev to Rybalko there. Spinning his way round. Well, winding up now, you can see. Going to be a big dismount, and it is, it's huge. Double finish. Nailed. Well, it was good in qualification. And it was good here this evening in the finals. So much complexity. 15.7 for Darnell Leva. Took him straight into first place. And there's his dad and coach. Well, just when you thought it couldn't get any more action-packed, up to the high bar came Kohai Uchimura. Now this guy has definitely had his fair share of gold medals during this World Championships. And big release there, well caught. And he said throughout this that the most important of these gold medals for him was that team gold for Japan. That's nice. Really into his swing now. Beautiful there. Yamawaki swinging in. Back up, Stalda. Well, he's winding in now, you can see. Full twisting, double with the trademark Uchimura landing. Well, he took a silver last year in the World Championships on this piece of apparatus. Huge over those releases. You can see there how much height he gets, the change of the grip, the combinations and the links. 15.83 puts him straight into first. Could it be yet another gold for Kohai Uchimura? Well, next up it was Brazilian Arthur Marinho Ayakawa. And this is a good swing. There's the catcher, straight. Straight into those swings, keeping that continuous movement going. Again, big release. And this has been a great championships for him and obviously for Brazil in general to showcase their gymnastics before next year's all-important Rio Olympic Games, which has been one of the big focuses of this championship. So wind it up. Double, slight hop, but he is happy with that. Well, I'm sure this guy is going to be a big star in Rio next year. 15.166 there, which puts him into third place. Well, another guy who'd been so impressive throughout this competition has been Manrique Lardue here of Cuba. He qualified in seventh for this final. Gets off. Big start there. He's got a lovely fluid swing about him. High there again. Releases from the bar, shoots up, and precision on that catch. Into the Stalder. Full one-arm swing there. Difficult work. Gliding through this. Well, winding it up now. High as you like. Well, what a finish there from Manrique Lardue of Cuba. This guy has come here to these World Championships and he has excelled himself. really pushing gymnastics in Cuba right up there in the spotlight. Big score, 15.6, which gives him a bronze medal. Now, there is the final standings. You can see another goal for Kohai Uchimura of Japan. Darnell Laver there with a well-deserved silver and a bronze medal for Manrique Lardoué, which means he will gain a berth to the Olympic Games. Championships this has been, specifically for Uchimura here. History was made in Glasgow, winning his sixth all-around World Championships title. And here he is again in his favourite position on that medal podium with another gold medal in the high bar final this evening.